So this is, it's kind of a pre-launch video, really, of the 12.4 Signature, which has been in development now for a couple of months in the field. I had released a few videos, but I'll put some cutaways in this one so you can see what the hell I'm on about, right? Bit of a show and tell for you, because we're going to be launching 50 of these at a special introductory price. But let me tell you what it is. So first of all, it's on this 40-foot, 12-meter-ish pole. We've got seven elements going up there, so the seven elements start at 80 meters. So we've got 80, 40, I don't need to go through all the seven elements. We've got a coil just over halfway up for 80 meters, and if you've listened to some of my live streams over the last couple of months, you'll know that's been going great guns. Right, a couple of things I want to run through. I'm going to talk later on in the video, and this is only a short video, but I'm going to talk about 30 meters and 10, because there's a decision to be made there. However, I've got a technical solution I'm working on. We'll run through the plate set. These are the bits that hold all the elements up. Before we do that, what I want to do is just to cover the topic of whether this is self-supporting or not. I don't believe in its current form it is, and the reason being is when we put an aluminium pole up the inside of the tube to support it, it worked absolutely great, other than the fact that 12 and 10 meters had a completely flat SWR and all our energy was probably going to ground. Okay, so that's no good. So I've got mine guide right now. We're working up a technical solution, and I've spoken to Brian at Barenco. In fact, he watched the video of the self-supporting hinge. And by the way, you can get Brian. So this is the hinge effectively that we bought. Brian watched that video and he has made me, without me even realizing it, a prototype which will suit better for tiltover. He wants me to stock these and ship them to the US as well. Brian does ship to the US regardless. So tiltover or not, right now it's not. I've got three guys at about 20 feet or 6 meters. Good, so that's covered whether it's self-supporting or not. Right, let's go through the plate set now, because this is absolutely, these are all prototypes. In fact, that is off the Classic. So that's a Classic plate, which we use on the DS Commander Classic, and that is the guy plate, as it so happens. Now, I want you to show you, just for sizing, right, we'll move these out of the way as we go through it. That's a little spreader. Actually, that's for the 18 meter nebula. And when I did all the prototypes, these is what I used. I also used this radiating plate here for the development of the 12.4. And you'll see why I'm showing you this in a minute, because that's also the ground plate we used. Now, I've spoken to Tyler, and Tyler done some drawings for us. Tyler's K7TDM. He's on the channel as well. And we've come up with this huge plate. Hopefully you can see that on camera number two, but if not, I'll hold up for camera number one. Look at the size difference of the ground plates, just because, you know, it's a permanent solution. We can, it's still in 3mm 5251 aluminium, but that is the size of the ground plate. Nice and big and easy. But what will assist us, even though I've got great SWR curves, size of the radiating plate has gone up. In fact, that's roughly the size of the 18 meter nebula plate there. But what will make the difference is when we get the separation on the elements. So this is right, the first spreader. So that is the size of the Classic first spreader right there. Look at the size difference between this and the 12.4. is truly massive. And that's because the cage of wires will go out further, so we'll get even better SWR curves. I mean, I'm really comfortable with the as it is, but it'll go even better. Okay, so that's the plate set. There are five nylon plates in total. Tyler has drawn it out for us here, and as you can see here, they're not circular. They're not, well, they're kind of octagonal as well, but they've got some lovely curves to them. So that is the second spreader, and they gradually go down in size. Third spreader, and then we go to this as well. So there's the fourth and the fifth. So very nice. So we these are to scale, I seem to remember, yes. So that's basically almost a copy of the top of the nebula, but then we've got an even smaller one up here as well. Good. So in terms of SWR then, I'm going to be really comfy. But it's also going to help with the next topic, which is what I talk about, which is 30 and 10. Because at the moment, 30 meters, right, which is 10.1 megahertz. Now, technically, that will resonate on three times that frequency. That's the next time it will resonate as a three-quarter wave. So that would be 30.3. In reality, it's a little bit higher, say 30 and a half. Now, on the classic, we have a 40-meter element, and we fold it back, and what happens is 15 meters comes down from 21.6 to 21. We lose about half a megahertz, and it doesn't affect 40 meters. So I've got an experiment to do where we build a 30-meter antenna, effectively, fold it over and keep cutting it until the maths work out how much of a fold over do we need to do 30 and 10. The advantage to that is that on a moderate ground, 10 meters is going to behave somewhat like a 5/8. Not quite, but it will resonate and it will behave very similar to a grounded, you know, with a ground map, 5/8. And we'll still get a fine tune on 30. Now, if I can pull that off, that'd be fantastic, because we're also getting a perfect tune on 6 meters as well. If I can't pull that off, then you will make a decision. I suggest what you do is you build a 30-meter element and use the ATU button for 10. Because let's face it, a lot of us have got like CB antennas and other options for 10 meters because you're heading nearly into the VHF spectrum. It's great. And when we went to the hills and we did our little DX Fest a couple of years ago with Tom and Tim and myself, we ran a load of stations on a 10-meter quarter wave. So I'm not saying you can't do it. It's just a lot of us have got options for 10. That's if you want 30. Just use your ATU button. But trust me, I've worked very hard to get that solution in. And I just wanted to say, so this price of this is going to be about £350. That's about $450 plus shipping. It's going to be the thick end of $500. And I thought, what competitors have we got in the market that you could get a vertical and do that? Well, there's only one, really, apart from that, is it the 6BT thing, whatever, with all the loading coils. But the trouble is, beyond about 20 meters, we start losing a lot of gain as you go down, particularly to 80. You know, you've lost, I don't know, 90% of your power or something. But I did actually look at the big IR Mark 4 vertical antenna, and I just selected, you know, normal options with an 80 meter coil, and that comes out at $2,500. So we could buy five of these for one of them, and we'll be supplying all the radials for you as well. You've still got to add that on. Incidentally, Step IR do, or Small IR, they do a smaller one. They do a 20-6, and that comes out about £1,500. But you could buy the Rapide for that. You got to remember, the advantage of a DX Commander is there's no moving parts, no circuitry, and if you wanted to play Whisper, for instance, you could just set your radio and go every band, right, for 24 hours. You don't have to touch a thing. There's no retuning, nothing. Just a bit of a sales pitch there. All right. This is just a... there'll be another video in 7 to 10 days with the actual launch, the link for you to buy. Okay, as I said, we're only launching 50 right now because there's a lot of work for us. We've got to source some boxes and that sort of thing. All right, so in the meantime, have a great time. I'm using my signature 12.4 myself, my prototype, my homebrew with all this drilled out and so on. I can't wait to get the original components through. The plastic plates arrive either today or tomorrow. And we get the aluminium plates next week. And then I'll build one, you see. I'll build one kind of with you. So when you're buying, you go, okay, well, I know what I'm buying now. All right. Cheers and beers, guys. All the best.